Welcome back, dear children. Now, in previous videos, you learn three laws of exponents. That is, first law, a raised to power m multiply with a raised to power n, we will get a raised to power m plus n, means in multiplication. In multiplication, if bases are same, then we can add the powers, or we should add their powers. Now in division, if bases are same, we should subtract the power. But how to subtract? M minus n. Order is too much important while subtracting the powers. Correct. As we know, m minus n is not same as n minus m. It is, subtraction is not commutative. That you already know. So that third law is there. What is third law? If negative power is there, then we can write that as 1 upon positive power. 1 upon positive power we can take. Now we will check the next law. That is, suppose 5 square raised to power 4 is there. What is the meaning exactly? If power is 4, it means that whatever is there in bracket, we have to write 4 times with multiplication. Whatever is there in that bracket, we can write 4 times. So we will write 5 square 1 time, 5 square 1 time, 5 square 2 times, 5 square 3 times, 5 square 4 times. This we can consider as x. X power 4. X, 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 x. 4 times. Correct? 4 times. So we can write. Now, individual, if you will check 5 square, we can write 5 multiply with 5 2 times. Same this also. So 5 multiply with 5 2 times. Same this also. 5 multiply with 5 2 times. And this is also 5 multiply with 5 2 times. Now, as if we will observe, 5 all are same numbers only. And these are in multiplication. How many times multiplication? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times. 8 times multiplication means we can write this as 5 raised to power 8. We can write it as 5 raised to power 8. And if you will check, here is 2, here is 4. 2 fours are 8, we are getting 2 fours are. It means that we will get the another law, fourth law of exponent, that is a raised to power m and bracket raised to power n, then we should multiply the power m into n. So this is our fourth law of exponents. So dear children, these four laws are very much important. If we are solving few problems, then we may use either one law of these four, or at a time 2, 3 or all laws we can apply. Correct? So please remember those laws. So dear children, I hope you understood. Yes? Thank you.